Hey everybody, welcome back to the Bry-Fy podcast. I'm your host, Bry-Fy the comics guy, and this is episode 271. Yes, 271 of the Bry-Fy podcast. We've been doing this for a very long time. Thank you guys for joining me. Of course, we haven't been doing this quite as long on YouTube, so you guys are on YouTube. Thanks for checking it out and seeing what this is all about. If you're new to the show, on YouTube here, we basically just break down some nifty nerd news, just three articles, three or four, just depends what I find throughout the week, and then I talk about it here on the podcast. And then if you want to continue over on the regular podcast, where you can find on podbean.com or bryfypodcast.podbean.com, where I break down a comic book to review. This week we are reviewing Motor Crush from Image Comics. I actually have a copy of it right here. Got it in trade paperback form. My friend over at Third Planet, she recommended this for my wife and me to check out. I decided to thumb through it and actually read a few of the issue or chapters, whatever you want to call them. It's really good. Really enjoyed it. So you'll get to hear my review later on the podcast. But for now, on YouTube, let's talk about some of the nifty nerd news that I wanted to discuss for this week. Up first, it looks like Will Smith is exiting, or quote-unquote exiting, from the sequel to Suicide Squad. Sorry, I had to think of the name there. Of course, we all know James Gunn is now going to be taking over the Suicide Squad movie. He, of course, is keeping Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn, but there's going to be a lot of shakedown. I don't know if keeping Harley Quinn or Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn was really James Gunn's decision, or more of DC like, hey, we can't let this go. This is our big moneymaker. No. Like, they have handcuffed her, made her sign a 20-year, I don't know how long the contract, but they got a moneymaker in Margot Robbie and Harley Quinn. I doubt they're going to let her go anytime soon. I think she's supposed to be in like two more movies. I'm not even sure. I think she's supposed to be in the Birds of Prey movie that they had planned, and now the Suicide Squad movie. So there you go. But like I kind of put with the quotations, I don't think it's so much that Will Smith like chose to leave the franchise, or if he was kicked out of the franchise. I think it was more of he only signed on to do one movie with Suicide Squad. I mean, you know, you kind of only sign on for one mission. It's the point of a Suicide Squad. And they just didn't renew his contract for the sequel. They just didn't say, come back, you know? And so I really don't think there's bad blood there. I think a lot of it just comes from people trying to make news out of nothing. But regardless, it was something, because for me personally, I loved Will Smith's character in Suicide Squad. I like Will Smith. Yes, he plays the same character in every movie he does, but it's not a bad character that he does. So I wasn't mad that he was in that movie. And although I'm not mad he's not a part of it going forward, I'm not like, yay, you know, like, I mean, I'm just kind of like, eh. I mean, to me, Suicide Squad, yes, one of the better DC movies up to that point. I mean, I still think Wonder Woman was better, and Aquaman is definitely better. So I don't know. We'll have to see where the franchise goes from there. I hear my son. He's trying to break in. Uh-oh. Anyway, let's move on to the next news story I wanted to talk about, and that's going to be Rotten Tomatoes has decided to stop letting people review movies before they come out, which, when you think about it, makes complete and total sense, which is probably why it didn't happen. So, yeah, and this came up because recently a lot of people were throwing shade at the new Captain Marvel movie before it even has come out. I think at this point of the recording, what are we, Sunday the 3rd, March 3rd, it still doesn't come out until like this Thursday is when it hits theaters, I believe. And people are throwing mad shade at it on Rotten Tomatoes, trying to give it like tanked score down, and it hasn't even come out yet. So the president finally decided, like, oh, hey, you know what would be a great idea? If we didn't let people say a bad movie was bad until they actually got to see it. So he claims it's not because of the Captain Marvel stuff. It's because it's been an ongoing issue, which I totally agree. It just happens that Captain Marvel happens to be one of the bigger named movies being tossed around, and that it's happening to at this moment. A lot of it has to do, Brie Larson had mentioned during some press junkets that she wants to, you know, diversify with it because it's been a lot of like white dudes my age. Well, I'm not. Well, I am white. I'm like half white. So, you know, basically a bunch of me's asking her a bunch of questions about a movie, you know, that stars a female, has people of color in it. Kind of like the same with Black Panther, except, you know, Brie Larson actually said that, which I get it, though. I mean, that job, whatever, the guys who review movies or talk to celebrities and movie stars about their movies is definitely dominated white male. And it's nice to see people of color, especially for what they've been pushing, not just with Marvel, but with Hollywood and the movie industry in general. You want to see more people in every facet of that world, you know, not just the stars and the people in the movies, but, you know, people behind the movies, people reviewing the movies, people talking about movies, doing YouTube channels like me about the movies. You want to see, you know, you want to see yourself represented. And yeah, you know, like I would love to see, you know, Tex-Mex people, Tex-Mex people, like more food. No, but you know, like a Hispanic or a half Hispanic person talking about movies, someone that I might relate to more than, you know, someone who's not half and half like me. You know, I'm the best. I'm half and half. Go in your coffee. Tastes great. Call me White Mocha. Anyway, the last bit of news that we're going to talk about is about DC, Warner Brothers, Warner Brothers Studios, DC, whatever you want the hell to call them, flip-flopping about if they want to do a connected universe or they don't want to do a connected universe. It seems like they don't even really know themselves. Because it always feels like every other week they've decided, hey, we're connected. Or, no, our movies aren't going to be connected. And this time they're really coming out again saying, while we want our universes to kind of be connected, we are not connecting our movies. So they're not going to go the Marvel route, which at this point, I wouldn't blame them if they did. But then again, you know, Aquaman, great movie that doesn't tie in anything really and doesn't bring in other movies or allude to other movie other than like, hey, you were in Justice League, you did that thing. But, you know, they don't tie in too heavily like the Marvel movies did. And I think that's a good thing. I think keeping the DC slightly different than Marvel, do what works for them, and doing strong single character movies is working for them. Wonder Woman was fantastic. Aquaman was just as great. And I think if they keep that up, seeing Shazam looks really cool. And I'm really excited for that movie, even though I know nothing about the character other than he used to be called Captain Marvel. And then legalese things happened. But I don't know. Like I said, DC kind of flips back and forth and back. Like they're still trying to find themselves, it feels like, in this whole connected universe thing that they want to do. I think a lot of it has to do with how critically Justice League and Batman versus Superman went. While, I mean, granted, they made billions of dollars, I mean, tons of money, all the money. People still had a lot of critical things to say about them, myself included. Not to say that they're bad movies, it's just Marvel kind of does a better job at it. Which it sounds bad, but then again, like you look at movies like Wonder Woman and Aquaman and my hype for Shazam, and those look very strong movies that can give Marvel a run for their money. Although at the same time, they're different characters, you know, so different characters get different movies. I'm super stoked about that. I'm super stoked for Captain Marvel to be coming out, even though, yes, we had a Wonder Woman movie, so what's a Captain Marvel? Well, it's a different character with a different story. So yeah, I'm excited to see that. And I think other people should be excited to see that as well. You're getting comic book movies. That's what we want. And plus, with Marvel, that's going to tie into Avengers Endgame, which is coming out later this year. So yeah, that's a big freaking deal. And then you have Spider-Man Far From Home all coming out. So I mean, there's just tons of great, great, great stuff coming out. So everyone just calm the frick down. That's what I'm trying to say. But really, that's it for the comic books I want to talk, comic books, the nifty nerd news that I wanted to talk about this week. Thank you guys for listening over on YouTube and just enjoying it. If you want to listen to the comic book that I have to review for this week, which is going to be Motor Crush from Image Comics. Please head over to bryfypodcast.podbean.com to list it there directly. You can also find it on the Apple iTunes, the Apple Podcast Store. I'm also on Stitcher Radio, Spotify. I think you can find it on Google Play. I don't know. You just Google Bry-Fy Podcast, you're going to find every... Well, actually, funny enough, if you go to YouTube and type in Bry-Fy Podcast, the first thing you will find is Walker the Geek, because he talked about me in one of his episodes and put my name in the title. And so he is the top search that you get on YouTube when you look up for me. But he's a good guy, so go check out his channel as well. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for just tuning in, and I will talk to you guys later. Bry-Fy out.